Hello, and welcome back to another episode of The Movie Palace, where we watch movies, some of which we've seen and some we haven't, and give you our commentary as filmmakers ourselves. Tonight we are watching National Treasure. Who's seen National Treasure? Let me specify. Who's seen National Treasure?
I've seen National Treasure.
Okay, you've watched it intently.
Multiple times, like across years.
The last time I watched it, I think I was in the fifth grade.
It's probably around that for me too. Joining us along on our watch party tonight, we are enjoying another delicious beverage called the Declaration of Gindependence. What are you guys' general thoughts on Nicolas Cage?
I think he's severely undervalued. He's become more popular since like jokes have been made about his acting career, but I genuinely enjoy him. Like, I've enjoyed so many of his performances. Are they kind of cheesy? Yeah, but they're popcorn movies. Like, that's what it's about. They sell popcorn. Like, I miss that kind of movie.
That's something I really like, too. I really like popcorn movies, just kind of as an idea.
I don't remember anything that happens in this movie.
So, Bree, you're basically watching it for the first time.
Yeah.
Basically, okay. Yeah. This grandpa with the mustache is going to be you guys in, like, 15 years.
15?
That gray?
Yeah, that gray. 15?
Do you know how stressful our career is?
Yep.
It is an occupation.
We're not far away from that, admittedly.
Shit.
I already feel a little lost.
They spent so much money on this. Because this is the only... I guess they could have used the same set, so it's not like a whole new build. But I spent so much money on this, and I don't remember.
I almost wonder if that's early green screen.
Early. This would be really good green screen.
I think it's every little boy's dream to be a member of the Knights Templar.
Oh. Yeah.
Well, I don't know. I was never a little boy.
Oh.
So.
That's okay. It's okay to be wrong sometimes. See, this feels like it could air on the History Channel. Like, this is one of those top 10 things you didn't know about the founders of America. It was also definitely a dream as a child to be a member of the Illuminati. Like, the deep belief that I had
the dream
and
of a
still
child?
Haven't removed from myself.
Bro, that's the dream of an adult.
That's what I'm saying.
Looking at a fully grown man over here wants to be part of the Illuminati.
Dude, no. It's
totally.
Oh, God. If somebody was like, hey, you want to be part of the secret organization that runs the world, I'm supposed to say no to that?
Imagine how many inside jokes they have.
At true power?
What would be one? If you were in the Illuminati, Grandpa, would you have a bit?
Alec would always
have
a bit.
North of the Arctic Circle, present day. That's one of my favorite conspiracy theories. That's what they're out here hunting for, the ice wall. They're going to film it with their iPhone. Sorry, iPod.
Okay. We've all seen the movie before, for admittedly not in a while. But what do you think the budget for this movie was?
Two snow cats. I mean, that's got to be a pain in the
ass. I'm springing it on you early, so you really don't know entirely what you're getting yourself into. But Nicolas Cage, I mean, he's not expensive, but he's not cheap.
87.
Yeah.
Okay. 90.
Estimated $100 million budget. It made a profit worldwide. It also made a profit just gross U.S. and Canada.
Wait, what the fuck is going on?
They're in the Arctic Circle. They're looking for the ice wall.
Catch up.
Are you
bitch?
Are you not following this shit?
What is the ice wall? What is that?
The ice
wall is trying to go through the ice wall.
The ice wall is what flat earthers believe, and flat earthers, who we can all agree, are fucking wrong. Like, if it's a fucking plate, the ice wall goes all the way around the plate, and the sun is in the middle, and it doesn't reach.
When people say that out loud, does it sound stupid?
Yeah,
there are people that believe
it's fucking wrong. Do you think this was Disney's like attempt at like renewing kind of like the Indiana Jones vibe?
100%.
Probably.
It's a little boy movie that is
definitely
also
is.
A grown man movie where it's like
little boy movies and grown man movies
are the same.
The call is coming from inside the house on this one.
No, 100%.
Yeah.
No. Because I guarantee you I'm going to enjoy this just as much as I did 15 years ago. It's solid. I mean, that was the wrong
that's
time.
That's you
brain.
In the morning.
That's me when I walk out and I see this fucking set. Imagine that. They were sent to, like, find this old shipwreck, like, with tons of cocaine on board. It's all around them. They just think it's snow.
Trying to catch little snowflakes on their tongues.
Oh, fuck, what shit. Do they find? Is it the Constitution?
No.
Not there yet. Not there yet.
Fuck.
That's also the wrong document.
I think I found something.
See, this is a point in my movie where my dad would go, that's the bad guy.
My mom's bit is she goes, I just don't like him. And I go, well, he's the villain.
Why was that his easiest available resource? He couldn't have pulled a Sharpie out of his pocket. He had to use his blood.
That's why nobody's ever found this before. Everybody walked up and was like, insert blood here. And they were like, All right, I'm out. As a British
no,
person.
Keep them the fuck out. No, I'm in support of building a wall as long as it's around that dumb fucking country, the United Kingdom. And you can quote me on that.
Doubled down.
There's a lot of really big actors right that now way. That are British yeah. and have been doing the American accent. Are you okay?
He's working on the court situation. It's a struggle. For
it
that.
Is.
You guys can't see it down here, but he's playing footsie with the fucking mic cord.
That he transcribed a resolution that 55 men
signed.
I'm like kinda right with Bree though. Like I can't.
I can't remember.
Like
I
can give you the gist of this movie, but as long as the gist is, Nicolas Cage, Hunter objects.
The last time I watched this movie,
he's gonna build a wall. He's gonna build a wall around the Declaration of Independence.
What if the next season of Movie Palace we watch all these movies the way dads don't
we
watch
stand
yeah.
the entire episode? You want to sit down?
I could always.
No.
I'm not watching.
I got some work. I gotta get done.
Yeah, it's lawn day. I gotta mow the lawn.
Gotta rotate the tires. You know. You want to come help?
So much mulch.
That's okay, kiddo.
So
much mulch.
Like 40 yards of mulch. But you can't shoot. They're on a burning Arctic ship that's on the ice wall on our flat Earth, and that guy's glove just lit on fire magically, which caused him to drop the flare.
Wait, but wasn't he on fire? How did he get away without his coat getting fucked up?
Because
he was on fire.
It's because the Earth's fucking flat, Bree. Yeah. Come on now, get with it. They're on the ice
wall. They're on the ice wall.
They're on the ice wall. The laws don't apply when you're on the ice wall.
Holy shit.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Were these done?
I am a powdered keg about to explode.
How much of these?
So there's your pyro budget right there.
I was going to say, how much is practical?
All of it is probably miniature.
That's my guess. This is practical.
I love me a good mini.
See, that's CG. Those two that were falling, they didn't fall right. 2004, it would be tough to make it look that good.
It's probably like Alaska or something.
Yeah, I don't think that they went to the moon.
No,
but
it's
somewhere that's empty, cold, and
you
expensive.
Could shoot that in fucking Minnesota. Yeah. Like, you just need some place that has snow and forest.
Yeah. Yeah.
Buckle up, bro, because guess what the next hour is going to be about?
It's going to be about him trying to steal the Declaration of Independence.
Can we talk about how kind of sexy Nicolas Cage looks here?
Bro,
he's got his collar popped.
This is
the hoochie daddy of treasure hunting.
Auga.
Yo, Nicolas Cage.
Cage is a conspiracy theorist. All he's finding is geocaches. And he thinks he's hunting down historical articles.
Look at his eyebrows. Those are the man. Those are the eyebrows of a man who hunts prehistoric articles. Or even historic articles. Or just articles of any kind.
Yo, can you say that line in Spanish? You said a lot of words and none of them comprehended. Fact.
Somebody's going to steal the Declaration of Independence.
How would you steal the Declaration of Independence?
I would follow the instruction manual.
I would go up to where they have it behind glass, and I would talk to the Marines who are guarding it, and I would be like, yo, news from up top.
What?
Papa Joe is going to let me take this for the weekend.
Don't worry
about it. Would I lie to you? Would this face lie to you?
We should take a trip to Washington D.C. and just see how many devious licks we can get from various state buildings.
Look at this editing.
I actually like this. This is really good use of CG.
Well, it's like a heist movie. That's why it's fun.
Yo, Papa Joe, news from up top, bro. News from Commander in Chief, okay? Himself. Yeah, Sleepy? Yeah, him. He's letting me take it out, giving it a walk.
I've driven past that building.
That's crazy, bro.
They won't let me into it anymore, so I just do a drive-by.
You spent a little bit too long looking at the fucking Declaration of Independence. They're like, he's going to steal it. Yo, I remember when snake cams first became a thing in, like, construction, like, home improvement, and they were so expensive. You know you can pick them up for, like, $40 now? Because that's what this is, and, like, it's a big deal, and I remember it being a huge deal when, like, my dad got one. And there was, like, that boo-boo picture quality. Now you can get your 6K Milwaukee snake. It doesn't have that gripper on it, but gripper
not much
gripper
does.
Optional.
Oh, was it honey?
No, Bree's just a bitch.
Copies.
And you saw where the art hand fucked up and they like scribbled it out.
You love when like the director is like, yeah, we just need more on the folder. We just need, just put a fucking sticky note there. And you're like, fucking fine. Copies. Yo, that's crazy. Can we have one of those?
Why?
The fucking espresso machine is back there.
It's got a keyboard.
I just want one. Document level. No problem. This shit isn't sick as much.
Sorry, just I gotta get one more shot.
I'm almost done, I promise.
Sorry.
Donde está mi mierda? Fuck, god damn it.
Yo, you grabbed him with the grippers.
He's grabbing him with his hooves.
This, god bless you. This was
just turned the mic to mute.
Yeah, but it was a bit. You're Nicolas Cage?
No. But I can't find it on my computer. That's me.
I like how they're cross-cutting these two, what are supposed to be intense action sequences. It was like Ben killing a brother.
But it's a heist.
You steal you that know? Declaration of Independence.
A heist is all about the cross-cut, though. I don't mind how they're doing that.
No. Like, I'm with it. I just wish that there was a little bit more intensity maintained in this. I don't know where anyone is. But I guess then it would probably become too intense. It's, you know. Tell him to bring out the whole ocean. Tell him to bring out the whole Bill of Rights. Tell him to bring out the tea so I can dump it in the Boston Harbor. See, that's why directors shouldn't be on walking on set. Because if you heard some of the bullshit that was going on, you would be like, shut the fuck up. Shut up. Shut up.
That's why if I ever am directing and I do happen to be on walking, I'm on a separate channel.
That's why I always beg for another GE channel. Because like I want to let them be able to shoot the shit. And I want it to not be everybody else's problem. Because they're going to shoot the shit. Come here. Give me that. I respect that.
Security.
Security.
Security. Over here.
Polizia. Attenzione, big pocket. The historical document snatching thing. They're in a red.
Holy shit.
She's hanging out at
the back. The historical document snatchy thing?
Snatching band.
Oh. Okay.
Because the white one is for children, the red one is for historical documents.
Understood. Understood. Shut
up, but I'll be okay. You probably can't see this, but Bree went to take a piece of my cookie, and she fucking shattered it.
Bree's got that dog in her. Women aren't allowed to think, actually. They just go along with crazy man delusion and steal the Declaration of fucking Independence. Look at man's little doodles.
This is what my walls look like.
That pipe is on his mind.
Every single filmmaker has a notebook with little doodles.
I just took mine out of my pocket.
What do you doodle about in there? Because it's
important. None of your business.
Sadness.
Longing and regret.
Those are my kids' names.
How would your father react if you stole the Declaration of Independence?
He wouldn't.
My dad would be like, yo, that's
pretty fucking sick, dude. How much is it worth? Yo, we post that shit on eBay?
Yeah, I think my dad would go, can you put that the fuck back, please? Nicolas Cage is actively keeping an eye out for Selena right now. There's girl dinner and boy dinner. What's dad dinner?
Steak. Divorce.
Steak, mashed potatoes, and three fingers of bourbon.
No.
Just a little taste.
Dad, do I need to put you in a home again? Can you tell me where the fucking letters are?
Give me the fucking letters.
I owe a lot of money to a lot of people. They're going to break my knees, Ben. I
donated them. My knees!
My knees. I just got them replaced, Ben.
Like La Llorona. Do you believe in that? Is that a thing in Puerto Rico?
Nope.
Makes sense. Y'all are y'all too smart.
Damn right.
Y'all too investigative.
We got the chupacabra.
Chupa?
I think I just got one of those at Taco Bell. I think I left one of those in the Taco Bell bathroom. A pupacabra.
Jack is a no sabo kid. Derogatory.
Imagine if you saw a guy like walk onto the White House grounds and like break a brick off of the White House.
I would ask him to grab one for me.
I see lots of colors. It's my job. It's my job to know what colors are.
Yo, I see color, but only in gels. Put that on a t-shirt.
They've got a gel for sunlight specifically.
CTS, color temperature straw. That's sunrise. CTO, color temperature orange, brings a daylight light to tungsten. And a CTB brings a tungsten light to daylight. Originally invented for use with different white balanced film or different color balanced film.
Wow.
I just imagine after Jack, you know, has had his National Treasure enclosure movie time, that he just sits back, relaxes, and watches an episode of Dora and learns Spanish.
I wonder what the reset on the pigeons was like.
Oh, God, dude.
They probably had like three or four sets of pigeons.
They had a pigeon wrangler. You good? Listening in on this call.
If they want the declaration back, do I not look good?
Fantastic. You come alone.
Fantastico.
I am so fucking lost. I'm not lost as an audience member. I'm lost as a director.
Oh,
I'm lost as to where they went wrong. I don't think the way they're raising the stakes is good. Because I don't think it's a sustainable way to raise the stakes through personal error. And that's basically what they're doing right now.
So, Bree, what are you thinking of this movie so far?
Are you getting eepy on us?
Absolutely not.
It's just a boy movie, isn't it?
No.
You are not the prime demographic for this movie.
I mean, that is a fact. I am not the prime demographic for this movie. I just wish I could follow along.
Oh, shit. Sorry. That's my favorite bit, that his dad just fucking appears occasionally. And he's like, son. And he's like, fucking, oh my God.
How did you get in here?
His dad's like, have you fucking figured it out yet? Because if not, you
should. Can you catch up?
You should get a real job. Go be a big boy and get a real job.
Jeffrey, down the street. He manages the Kohl's. I could talk to him. I see him every morning.
It's an enemies to lovers.
Yo, he got that history teacher riz.
Yo, real. Most history teachers also have baseball ass. Baseball ass is plump, round, voluminous.
Scrumdiddlyumptious.
It makes you want to go eat.
Before the next episode, can you tilt that light down or something?
Who the fuck do you think you are?
What do you think you're doing asking me to move my fucking light? I've been doing this longer than you've been alive, pal.
That one was for free. The next one will cost you.
Good luck.
Also, this could have been a short film.
This? Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, no, this film is definitely longer.
I think it would be better if it was a short film.
Do they ever find the treasure?
Let me tell you something. There's no treasure.
Let it land.
Where do you think this family was January 6th?
Oh.
In the Capitol.
Dude, they were on comms, coaching people through it.
Do it. And she goes, yeah, I'm body doubling.
Wait, what room is he standing in? What is this? What did they do?
They're in an underground cave.
This is where Jesus died.
Son. Okay. There is treasure. There's treasure. You have to listen to me. Morty, you gotta steal the Declaration of Independence, Morty.
Yo, talk about secondary shafts. Am I right?
I've always been considered a secondary shaft. Background.
No. said that. Oh my god, there is treasure.
They made the friends along the way and also got the treasure.
Like a double whammy.
There's is more this... treasure than expected.
Oh my god, it's so much treasure.
That's
how
a
are
triple
they gonna,
whammy.
How are they going to take
We're
it all
gonna
out of
rich,
there?
We're going to be rich,
Morty. How do they take it all out of there?
They don't. They give it to a museum. Dude, editing this episode is going to be a fucking bitch. It's going to be terrible.
You guys have fun with that. Professional, if you will. In Passenger Princesa.
So that Spanglish went hard.
That's what my mind sounds like. You got to keep an eye out for Selena.
What? Why are you looking at me like that? Why are you looking at me like your hinges don't act right?
Wait, so he said no to the money?
Well, he gave all but 1% of it away. He retained 1%.
The U.S. government would not allow you to retain 1% of it. They would be like,
how about, hear us out.
No.
We take it all.
What do you think?
Thoughts?
How many movie points would you rate that movie?
Ooh. You know, because of the amount of times that I've watched it, and like, kind of what, like, the amount of time in my life that it's like sustained being pretty good, I'm gonna give it a solid 260 movie points.
260 movie
260
points. All right, Bree.
57.
Whoa. I'm gonna give it a solid 5 stars.
I pledge allegiance.
You want a piece of me?
I'll take a fucking piece of you.
You want a piece of me?
Yeah.
You want it?
Let's do it.
You got it.
And on that note, we're going to let you go. This has been an eventful episode. We hope you enjoyed the Movie Palace National Treasure. Until next time, stay frosty. Signing off. So, night-night, Alec.